Hello, I'm Andrew Pritchard. Thank you for watching today's Northeast Regional Forecast, brought to you by Nutrien Ag Solutions. Well, as we looked at the pattern over the last couple of days, we've been watching this big ridge across Alaska. And what that's done is it's allowed a lot of warm air to be displaced to the north. Alaska is quite warm across compared to their first week of April standards. And as we displace that warm air northward, we've also displaced some cold air to the south. And that's what's kept the central and the eastern U.S. a bit cooler over the last couple of days, but the pattern is changing, and it's changing quickly. So we begin to loop this just over the next several days. We see the ridge here begin to be displaced and weakened. A very strong and a very active Pacific jet stream keeps things progressive across the lower 48, and that's going to keep us a bit active here in the northeast and across a big chunk of the central and the eastern United States, as well as keeping us a bit warmer. We're going to shift towards a warmer pattern, warming up quite nicely, especially as we head towards the weekend. So what does that look like? We'll just take a quick look at the European model here. Precipitation type over the next week, just really showing the active pattern here. We won't look at specifics here until we get a little bit later into the video. But as you're looking at the northeast here, you see this nor'easter off the coast as we begin the week. I'll go ahead and let this start back over. This nor'easter moves up here Tuesday and Wednesday. Thursday, we watch a storm system tracking across the central United States that moves into the northeastern region as we begin the weekend, Friday and Saturday. As we get into the early part of the week now, we are into Tuesday, seeing more precipitation tracking through the area as another storm system lifts out of the central United States. And as this loop ends on Thursday evening, we've already got another well-defined low-pressure system here across the central U.S., and that will track towards the east-northeast, moving through the northeastern region next weekend. So as we look at the pattern over the next 10 to 14 days, certainly looking like rainy days or days with precipitation are going to outnumber the dry days across a big chunk of the country, and that does include the northeastern region. Taking a little bit more of a specific look here, looking at the high-resolution NAM model's precipitation type forecast just over the next couple of days, and that's going to show us this storm system really intensifying off the coast, off the east coast, bringing some coastal precipitation to the region, maybe some snow across parts of Maine. But as this goes through the area Wednesday, it'd be Tuesday night getting into Wednesday morning, and then Wednesday during the day, perhaps seeing some snow across Maine here, getting into here's Wednesday afternoon now as that moves off. But here, look as this loop ends Thursday afternoon, already watching the next storm system tracking into the area. Total snowfall, again, I don't expect much inland snow here. It's going to be across northern Maine where we see perhaps a couple of inches, maybe a trace here on the backside as some colder air works in, some snowflakes mixing in with the precipitation across parts of Massachusetts and then New Hampshire and Vermont, and then coastal parts of portions of Maine. But again, we can look at liquid precipitation here, and this really is going to be a coastal event, not anticipating significant precipitation to make it inland. With this particular storm system here, this is just Tuesday and Wednesday that we're looking at, not talking about the storm systems that come to follow later this week into next week. Those are certainly going to be bringing more significant precipitation chances to the entire Northeast region, and we can see that here. As we just look at the next week's precipitation, a snapshot here from the European model, and it shows a pretty disorganized look, and that's because, again, we've got several storm systems tracking through, and the details on each one of those are not quite set in stone at this point, but we look at this, and I see the entire region seeing the chance for about a half an inch to up to 2 inches in some of the areas that perhaps get hit repeatedly by these storm systems. But again, over the next week or so, looking at about an inch on average across the northeast region here with locally higher and lower amounts there. As we look at a little bit closer picture here again from the north, the European model looking at the northeast region, we can go ahead and step through time here Tuesday evening, getting into Tuesday night, and now Wednesday morning, again, that's when we see this well-defined storm system quite a ways off the coast here, but again, bringing perhaps some rough seas, some, you know, gusty conditions across the northeast region, and then some significant precipitation to coastal portions of the northeast. We can step out through time a little bit more. Some quiet weather works in on the backside here. High pressure late in the week. This will be Thursday and Friday. But that next storm system is already on its heels here, getting into Friday evening now, seeing precipitation work into the northeast. Maybe some snow on the leading edge of that, but I'll show you here. Total snowfall expected to be rather light. Really, just with each one of these, if you see some snow, the odds are it's going to be light and it's going to be melting quick, and I'll show you that as well in just a moment. This exits the area here Saturday morning. We're quiet for the weekend, very warm for the weekend. I'll show show you temperatures in just a moment as well. But here you go. We work into the day on Monday, Tuesday now, and then getting into Wednesday. Well, this will be Tuesday night, but seeing another significant storm system track through the area. The center of low pressure well off to the north of this one. A week out, so details unclear there. But again, as I mentioned, I'm not anticipating any major snowfall with any of the storm systems I'm seeing at this point. If that changes, of course, I'll let you know. But it looks like the track with these going to keep things mostly rain across the northeast region. And here you have it, total snowfall. This is everything going through the next week. Spotty locations here picking up perhaps 2 inches or more. Some of the higher elevation areas here. But this is, again, going to be rather light, rather spotty. And any snow that does accumulate here is going to be melting rather quickly as we shift towards a warmer pattern. This is taking a look at temperature anomalies. As we loop this out over the next week, you'll just see again, it's a busy loop. You don't have to focus in on the details. Just notice the overall trend. We see those blues and greens begin to be replaced by the warmer oranges and red colors, and that signifies a significant warm-up across the central and the eastern United States. We're looking at a map of snow depth now, and we can loop that over the next week, and you'll see pretty rapid melting happening across the northern plains, where we're watching the threat for some flooding there as the snow melt runs off into the rivers. But you can also focus in on the northeast, and you'll notice a couple opportunities for snow to fall and accumulate here, but look how quickly it melts there as warm air returns on the backside of these storm systems. So perhaps again the chance for some snow accumulating with one or two of these storm systems across parts of Pennsylvania and New York. But it's a snow that's going to stick around for maybe a day or two, if not less, as warm air quickly moves in on the backside. Finishing up with a quick look at temperatures, high temperatures for the next several days. Tuesday, looking at 40s and 50s broadly across the entire region. Tomorrow, getting into Wednesday, we start to see those warmer temperatures creeping in from the south. Kind of pushed back a little bit on Thursday, but then we start to warm up rapidly into the weekend. Friday, now Saturday, Sunday, 60s working their well, working their way well to the north. There we go. Overspreading much of the northeast region as we end the weekend. Really beautiful conditions expected here as we head through the weekend. Warmer still as we head into Monday there. Thought I was done there. One more day thrown in there at the very end. As always, Eric Snodgrass is going to have an in-depth look at the evolution of the next 1 to 2 weeks in our Thursday morning ag forecast video. And I'll have an update on the northeastern region with our Friday morning update. Have a great day, and I'll talk to you on Friday.